Good morning. My name is Judit Barroso, and I am the weed scientist at CBARC, that is a research center of Oregon State University near Pendleton. Today, I have a question for you. Who wants to have resistant weeds? I cannot hear you. Maybe it's because nobody wants. For those of you that don't want to have resistant weeds, diversifying weed management is the key. And for those of you that are no-till growers and rely heavily on chemical control, it's very important to diversify your chemicals' mode of action as much as possible. You may have heard me in the past few years that we have Russian thistle populations in Oregon that are resistant to glyphosate. And more recently, we learned that there are a few downy brown populations in Washington that are resistant to glyphosate as well. So my next question is, who wants downy brown or Russian thistle glyphosate resistant in their fields? Again, I don't hear you. Nobody, right? In the past 3 years, we've been working to learn how to control Russian thistle and other weeds with residual herbicides in fallow as an alternative to glyphosate. Particularly in this video, I am going to show you the effect of metribuzin compared to glyphosate on winter annual weeds. First of all, this is how the fallow field would look without any chemical control since it was worked in the fall. This plot is our control that has two glyphosate applications of 32 ounces per acre each. The glyphosate was applied in mid-November and the end of March. This plot is metribuzin applied once in mid-November at 10.5 ounces per acre. This is the same rate of metribuzin but applied at the end of March. And this is the same rate but split in two applications, one in mid-November and the other at the end of March. And in this slide, you can see the same treatments, but in the second repetition of the trial that had 4 repetitions. You can see that the weed control of metribuzin applied in late fall or in a split application is comparable to the 2 glyphosate applications. The late winter application is not that good to control winter grasses such as downy brome, jointed goldgrass, or volunteer wheat, but it will hold the broadleaf weeds better than glyphosate that doesn't have a residual effect. You may be thinking about the effect of metribuzin in the following crop, and here we are. We are also conducting carryover studies to see the effect of the residual herbicides on the following crop, particularly on winter wheat. We will be harvesting these plots to study this effect. However, we have already collected data from the carryover trial in 2019, and we did not see any difference in winter wheat yields with metribuzin compared to glyphosate or with 2 other residual herbicides, which commercial name are Spartan Charge and Fierce. If you want to know more information about these other residual herbicides that we are studying, please contact us or take a look at the Oregon Weed magazine published last December. And with that, I would like to thank my technician Jennifer Gurley for her hard work on the herbicide trials, and to Oregon Weed Commission for the funds received to make this research possible. I hope to see you all on June 9th for the virtual session of questions and answers. And until then, I hope you stay safe. Cheers. Bye.